Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is Thursday Night Football on EA Sports. We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one, between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers. I'll see you again at halftime as we preview some of the action coming up on Sunday. But for now, it's Thursday Night Football, and on the call, as always, it's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. They come in off a loss in the season opener, which doubled as the home opener.
And when you lose that way, at home, season opener, it almost feels like two losses. So it's a big fight to get yourselves ready to go to play the next week.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Bucs, they were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
The first game's out of the way. Time to buckle down for the long season ahead, and we're off in week two. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They'll be led out by the only 6-time Super Bowl champion in league history. In his 20th season now, Tom Brady.
And we keep hearing from people who are waiting to see the drop-off in his play. I'd quit worrying about it. I'd quit looking for it. He says he wants to play until he's 45. Is there any reason to doubt him? His skills have shown no sign of declining.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll run it now out of the gun. It'll go as a loss of 3 right away, and it's second down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Here's Brady to throw. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A gain of 32 that time. All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week, it's how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Shaq Thompson making his presence felt on the sack. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. They run the counter. It's Vaughn. He won't go down. And he's got some space here. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
With these Thursday night games, sometimes you get those quick turnarounds. You wonder how a team's going to start. They started really well.
Everyone's always wondering, going into a Thursday night game, who has their legs, who has the overall health of a team. But mentally, if you get that early edge, the other team might think to itself, it's been a short week. We're not really ready to go. You might run them into the ground that way. That's why getting that early score means a lot.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So that drive spanned 5 plays. And the last play, a really nice run that culminated in the touchdown. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So here are the Panthers now under head coach Ron Rivera. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, the former Louisville Cardinal, Teddy Bridgewater.
Coming off of a loss their last time out, I think he's just seeking to make a bigger impact on the game. He threw a touchdown pass, didn't throw an interception. I think he just wants to jump those numbers up in terms of flinging it around and letting his receivers get into the end zone.
The former Florida Gator, Jordan Scarlett, the rookie with the carry. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it 2nd and 14. Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down. And the offensive starters for the Panthers.
It's a quick turnaround right out of the gate because there's a lot to cover in a short period of time. But the best teams, they simplify before they go play that Thursday night game. And they also believe it's way better to get your Thursday night game out of the way early before the body has been through too much. So if you ask people on scheduling, they want to play it early, not late.
To throw, Bridgewater. He'll get that to DeValve, the tight end. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be 4th down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the 3rd down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up 4th down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3 and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Pulled in at the 24. It'll wind up being a net of 41. 9-yard return, 50 on the punt. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
They'll run on 1st down. It's Vaughn. And he'll rumble for about 5, up close to the 40. And we get a glance now at the Buccaneer offense.
Mike Evans is exactly what you're looking for in a receiver in today's NFL. Big, quick, can flat out run, but makes great adjustments when the ball is in the air. Ranked number 3 last year in receiving yards, 1,000 yards receiving every year he's been in the league.
From the 39, Brady, and the catch made by Johnson. Legs still churning.
Like a giant pinball.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10.
To throw is Brady.
And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Let's go.
25 yards that time.
And with the Buccaneers' new coaching staff, you have to figure they're going to want to use O.J. Howard a little bit more this season. 34 catches, 565 yards last year, but that was in only 10 games. 6'6", 251, and can run. Find a way to get him the ball as they just did there.
Wait, set, fly, 20.
Watch by four. On yard.
450.
Shotgun now for Brady. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, but it'll be second and goal. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. To throw, it's Brady. And that will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Two incompletions haven't moved him any closer, and likely throwing again, you'd have to think, on third and goal here. Now Brady on the bootleg. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, yeah, Tampa Bay.
That's the way you make the spin.
Nick Vanette, his first touchdown of the new season as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. No surprise there. Third and goal down here. That's where they're going to look for their tight end.
Yeah, you want that big guy running his routes because it doesn't matter who they cover him with. If it's another big guy, he might use his bulk against him. If it's a shorter defender, might go over the top. Either way, you tend to find a little bit of a mismatch in that area.
Gay is on for the point after. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go!
Carolina getting set to take the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. From the shotgun to McCaffrey, and he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense just going to gang up on the run and set them down.
And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. Ouch, you thought you had the defensive stand. Roughing the passer wipes it out.
What does every defense talk about? 3 and out, right? Thought they were able to get off the field. Not so.
A bad time for a roughing penalty. And they get the gift of a 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. On the draw, it's Scarlett. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Now Scarlett. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go. A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
Bridgewater now. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And it's caught. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there. A good-looking drive so far for the Panthers, and a first down here. This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. And again, it's Bridgewater. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
All right, Captain, it's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge 2 pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on 3rd and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. 3rd and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack, and now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker room and then try and add to it in the second half. But there's a part of me that looks at this and says, first half going my way. I have a little bit of a cushion. Let's go ahead and try and extend things. If you've got some good plays drawn up.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. K1 short with a sack. That's 315 pounds of man right there.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Another try after the first down sack. Brady. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up 3rd down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Now Brady. He hits Gronkowski on the out route, and he's able to get up here to the 26. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Fourth down, and the Bucs trot out the former 49er Bradley Pinion to punt it. Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. We're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. On second and a yard, Bridgewater, he gets it to Thomas. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So negative yardage, a loss of three on second down, and that leads to a tough third down call. Here's Bridgewater. Completes it to Samuel. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you guys in a moment. But first, the NFL season is in full swing. Let's show the good folks what we've got in store for us later this weekend here in Week 2. In the early window, lots of good matchups to choose from.
You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken at the three. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Bridgewater to throw it. Side here, complete. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16. They'll run it with Scarlett. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
But if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
Yeah, 70 ending. I'm scared. Single.
On second and 11 now. Bridgewater, quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A big play there with his first career NFL touchdown as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And it's 21-3. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Let's go!
Carolina getting set to take the field. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position, the ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence.
Okay,
confident the kicker could make it. And even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold him.
They turn to Scarlett again. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Bridgewater. And he's got his target. That's Moore. A big play there for Carolina. 43 yards. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
Give them maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. The intended receiver was set to valve, and now it's third down. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. Throwing is Bridgewater. Got his target, Samuel. 21 yards there on third down.
Let's go.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run.
Watch the curl, watch the curl.
This is Scarlett on the carry, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter of play. On third down, Bridgewater. And that is incomplete. Another good drive, Charles, but it looks like another that might end in a field goal try.
They've made some nice plays. They've given themselves opportunities. But as you noted, another field goal attempt coming up. And that's not how they want to end drives. They've got to figure out what's the final touch that they need.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Set the valve. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Gano the extra point, and it makes the score 21-10. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. This will be fielded at the 8. Spins by. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field.
Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll keep it on the ground. Vaughn refusing to go down. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards there. A first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
On first down, it's Vaughn. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Offensively, with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock. Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they won't put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's going to be caught. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. And now they come up and spike it to stop the clock.
Hey, set, 380.
On 2nd down, it's Vaughn, and he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Throwing, Bridgewater. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. To throw is Bridgewater. Going underneath here, the tight end DeValve. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 7 yards there and a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Bridgewater again. And he's got it complete to Anderson. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On first and 10, Bridgewater. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Here's Bridgewater. And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Panthers, they're able to draw a bit closer.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a 2-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a 2-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Extra point try, good by Gano. And the lead is down to 11 at 28-17. So the drive there took 6 plays. 2 scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. Then the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. They'll keep it on the ground. Born. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. Now a give right side. It's Vaughn. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Now the Panthers going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So now the Panthers down by two touchdowns. And time, a huge factor. Field goals, useless at this point. They need two touchdowns, and they need them in short order. A first down throw for Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as his guys are back within a single score.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this, and I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Gano now to add the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. So with just over a minute to play, this becomes a make or break onside kick. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
He's going to look deep down the field. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. A big play there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass. And that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now it's the Panthers' turn. Trailing in this one now. 55 seconds remaining. It's an extremely tall order in front of them, but they've got the ball with a first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. To throw, Bridgewater. And he's certainly been a huge factor. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Ndamukong Suh with a sack. We've seen that a ton since he entered the league in 2010. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Buccaneers, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week. Meanwhile, for Carolina, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Glendale to take on the Cardinals.